Hey, this week's video, we're going to fire up the grill and we are going to grill us up some ribs, some beef ribs, and we're going to baste them with our barbecue sauce.
You gonna make me cook everything?
Isn't the deal that I kill it and you cook it?
Yeah, sure.
All right, first up, what do we do? What do we gotta do? We're gonna grill these. These are beef ribs.
So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna turn on the grill and we're gonna heat it up to about 250 degrees.
Gotta fire it up.
Place the ribs on the grill. We are going to set them bone side down first.
With the fat up.
Fat up, bone side down to start.
And that fat melts, and it melts in through the ribs?
Yeah.
It helps make it tender?
So we have this casserole dish that we're going to put in the grill. We're going to put some water in it, and we're putting water in it so that as the water evaporates while it's in the grill, it'll reintroduce moisture to the meat so that the meat doesn't dry out.
Just for clarification, that's on the grill and not in the grill.
As the ribs cook, we're gonna check them every 20 minutes and we're gonna baste them with our barbecue sauce.
And that is Nine Diamond Ranch barbecue sauce, hickory apple, and that is available right now on our website. And that is canned up by the same cannery that is doing our jams for us. So you can order this now. It's great barbecue sauce. So we have the ribs on that side over there, and we got our water dish back there. We have one burner on. That's this side here. So we get a little more indirect type heat. And the ribs are over on that side. You what?
Forgot to baste them. I gotta open it up and baste them now.
Now we gotta baste them. Forgot all about the baste. It's all about the baste. So one thing that we are running into, even though we just have one burner on the grill, is keeping it low enough. You gotta have it low and slow. The temperature should be around 250. Our temperature is staying around 300. And some of the problem is the grill's sitting in the sun. So it's getting the sunshine on it. And then we have one burner on as low as it can go. And we're still hitting 300. So. It shouldn't be a problem. It's going to cook. They're just going to cook a little bit faster than what we want. It's another 20 minutes. Time to flip them again. So we're going to flip these every 20 minutes until they're done. When are they done?
When they reach, I think it's 200 degrees in internal temperature.
Internal temperature, 200 degrees. Where are we getting the side now? Oh,
yeah,
you're going all four sides.
Yeah, you fell asleep on the porch there.
Yeah, I fell asleep and you flipped them. And after this, I think I'm going to go sleep a little bit more. It's hot out here and it just makes me sleepy. Oh, they do look good. They sure do. And especially with our barbecue sauce on there. That is some good stuff. Yeah, before the summer is over, get yourself some of our hickory apple barbecue sauce. You will like it. It's good. It's good stuff. So our ribs are basically done at this point. They are just under 200 degrees on the internal temperature. So we're going to baste them one last time and give them just a little bit longer here. And then we're going to take them off and we're going to cut into them and see how they are. Well, we have used the whole jar of barbecue sauce on these ribs. So they should be real good. There's a nice crust on some of them. They're looking pretty good to me. Those are looking and smelling awesome. Now we're going to take them in the house and we're going to eat them. You ready to try some ribs?
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Did you come to help too? Clean up? Food's done. Time to show up. Now I'm going to clean the grill real fast. The way I do it, just turn it up all the way and burn everything off.
Going to the inside.
Yeah. This thing will hit like 700 degrees. So, really crank it up and burn everything right off of it. There's not a whole lot of cleaning. Then once it cools, just brush it. Yeah, anyway. Well, looks like we're around the 680 right now. Almost 700. I don't care what it hits, as long as it burns the stuff off and does it quick. I want to get in the house, I want to eat some ribs. So I'm not going to say maybe I had a sauce accident or something and that's why I have a different shirt on. But we are in the house and we're going to try these ribs. These ribs came off the grill now. They're very tender. I picked this one up with the things to pick it up with and it fell apart. So we're going to try it first without adding more sauce. I'm going to sample it with the sauce that was cooked on there. So it's very tender, as you can see. And it took about, it was more like 3 hours on the grill on a low heat in order to reach the proper internal temperature. That's very nice. The sauce has caramelized on top of there, on the meat. So we left a fat cap on to cook this, and that has made it very tender. A lot of that is melted, and what's left, you just cut it off while you're eating. So I'm going to add a little more of our barbecue sauce once again on top of it. Little ladle for it. I just put it on the side. You almost don't even need a knife. It kind of pulls apart. Well, the rest of the family is finishing up cooking some other things and they're going to be joining me for dinner here. I just wanted to sample this and get it on video. Oh, that's excellent. You want to try this?
Yeah, sorry.
I don't know if I want to share anymore. I think I'm just going to keep this for myself.
That is mean.
That is not even true. I am joking. Woo, they're starting to bring the other stuff. We better wrap this up. What do we got here, honey?
Got ribs and sweet potatoes.
Mm-hmm. Looks like they already killed off one tray of ribs. And most of the sweet potatoes.
Yep.
Good.
I'm gonna cut that one in half. Getting into the second tray now. So the cut of meat that we're eating here is called short ribs.
Beef.
And it's beef.
and it's called short ribs. And we have steer butchered, so it's custom butchering, so you can get that. I don't often see short ribs in a store. But if you wanted the same cut of meat, it's called short ribs. So if you go to a grocery store where they have a butcher department and you ask them for short ribs, you'd be getting, I believe, the same cut of meat, right?
Mm-hmm. It should be.
Should be. Theirs might be more trimmed up. The fat cap on those ribs is what helps it cook and become more tender. The fat and the bone gives the meat the flavor and tenderness. And it has to cook for a very long time. Like, these took 3 hours to cook to get this tender and this good. So, yeah, it takes a while.
God bless you, and thank you for watching. We appreciate you all and hope that you turn in next time.
And if you like, and if you appreciate this video, hit the like button and share it with your friends. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't done that already. And check out our website to try out this barbecue sauce. I think you're going to like it.
You know, the whole time you were having, like, your hand like this, like, you were like...
Should I not be doing that?
I don't know, I just noticed it's something that you do.
You do stuff with your hands. You never know what to do with your hands in pictures. Well, if you've enjoyed this video, please share it with your friends and hit that like button if you haven't done so already. And while you're at it, go ahead and subscribe to our channel. We put out new videos every week, every Friday morning. And if you'd like to receive notifications when we do upload the next video, hit that notification bell. And check out our channel. We have several videos just like this one or very similar. We do various things, including hiking, biking, boating, fishing, builds of various kinds, mostly outdoor activities. Some homesteading is thrown in there as well. Thank you. We'll see you on the next one.